On the 15th day of Feyenthal, 1403 post-dark times, the year of the dragon, the year of the Gorgon, excuse me. The party gathers in a dusty shanty town aptly named Rat Village. The already slim pickings of bush tucker and rancid water has been running even drier since the fire started, and everyone lost their collective eds. Excuse me. See if I can do this. Okay. The fires could be anything. Nobody really knows yet. One thing everyone does know for sure is that the crops that haven't gotten burned yet are getting choked out by ash, at least in this region. Volcanoes, dormant for millennia, are suddenly rubbling or even spewing forth hot ash. Sparks and ash flung high in the morning winds and then thrown down again in the middle of the cold night. More immediately, there are fires to extinguish if any food or water will be found here. What do you do? And you guys are on the southwest side of town, heading north.
Do we assume that we know each other at this point, or
yeah,
just five strangers? Okay.
I was assuming that you knew each other and knew each other, but just met.
Okay.
So, and you're probably together for survival reasons. As well as if you've got your own individual quests going on, but to do that, you have to survive too, so.
Okay. Well, I would. Lauren would probably ask the group if we're. If we want to put out the fire. Or fires.
I don't really care either way, as long as we can get the supplies we need. Doesn't really bother me if we put them out or if we let them burn. Cal?
So, Kalindor's, little antenna go up in the air, kind of. You see his mandibles open and close. He's like, food, cooking. And he starts to wander off towards the smell, which would probably be the fires.
Right now, there are fires burning on the north side of the village.
Oh, yeah. Well.
And at the for the time being, while Six is gone, Twist will just pretty much go along with what the group is doing.
I would follow Kalindor.
There are quite a few villagers running here and there, and you can see that they've either run out of water or never had any to begin with. There's a bucket brigade going at some of the different points, and they're using sand to throw on the fire, which, you know, it works pretty well.
So I can see them putting out food and being able to grab it with the sand. I think what I'm going to do is I would probably grab like some of the buckets from them and, you know, start throwing it on the fire so that I could grab my own food.
Okay.
Yeah, I would help by going to the closest fire with a bucket of sand and try to assist taking the fire out or putting the fire out.
And I recommend keeping your tokens together. There's not going to be any combat right now. But if there was, or something that I have to resolve that the formation of the PCs matter, then when that triggers, wherever you're standing is where you're standing when that triggers. So be advised.
Okay. Cool.
I'm just going to start carrying handfuls of sand instead of using buckets, because I'm a pretty large guy. I'm just going to start throwing sand.
Okay. Anybody who has a survival ability can, if you're proficient, you can make a survival check.
I'm proficient. It's not great, but I'm proficient.
Yeah, as long as you're proficient. Okay. You've got the crop fires out.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah, are any of these crops I would assume none of these crops are harvestable.
Not that you can see immediately, no.
Okay. I can't like make a perception check or anything, or a nature check to see if there's anything salvageable here.
Yeah, you can.
Doesn't matter which one, or.
I think nature would be best, or survival, whichever's better. Okay.
Wow.
I don't know what I just did, but it rolled two. But
that's because no, I have the rolls set to auto advantage because I don't like turning it on and off anytime you've got advantage or whatever. So anytime you don't have advantage or disadvantage, you just ignore the second number.
Okay, so always take the first number.
Yeah.
Cool. Can you guys see the dice too? I've never seen it roll or anything rolled that way before in roll 20.
Yeah, I have them on. I'm pretty sure you can all turn them off individually if you don't want them on. But I like having them on.
Yeah, no, me too. I think this is really cool.
Enable advanced dice, enable 3D dice. Automatically roll 3D dice.
Okay, Elorin is able to salvage. Four days worth of crops and berries.
Is that 4 days for the, you said you're tracking by party, so that's 4 days right. For us all?
Okay. Yeah, so I'm just going to track everything as a group, so that puts everyone at 18 days worth of resources now.
And do the different colors mean, is that like food, water, or something else, or?
Food and water, and then the green is like, I don't know, up for grabs. So.
Stamina or something.
I'm sorry, did you say up for crabs?
Up for crabs, of course. That's what I meant to say. You have 18 crabs. I don't know if Kalendor is a cannibal, but there's lots of crab to be eaten.
Fun fact. Crabs are scavengers who will eat anything they can find.
I think after getting those resources, Elorin would probably still keep trying to put these other fires out here at R2.
Okay. Go ahead and make that survival roll again.
Jeez.
All right, natural 20.
All right, so Lauren's doing all of our roles.
The villagers are looking a little more favorably at you. this looks like kind of a backwater, so they're probably shooting Kalendor some dirty looks, but I guess they figure since you're putting the fires out, they're okay for the moment.
Do we know the name of this town by chance, or this area?
It's Rat Village.
Oh, yeah, I see that.
You guys are getting lucky here, okay.
Is there anybody injured in the wreckage? Or can I make a perception check for that?
Yeah, you can make a perception check. I don't know if Axiom meant to keep Ori down here, but I'm guessing you didn't, so I'm gonna move this character up with the group. You can see a number of burn victims, and you can also see one fire still burning at the northeasternmost house in the village.
Okay, I think we should prioritize putting out the fire then, before we start grabbing victims. Like, helping victims, I don't mean like just snatching them.
I mean, speak for yourself, but...
Right, correct. So I'm gonna move to the last fire.
I see everybody rushing over there, and I'll follow, assuming that there's food.
And probably I'll try to do a roll this time to see if I can put out the fire with the sand. Just start shoveling paws or handfuls of sand on the fire.
Okay.
I'll do the help action.
Okay.
It didn't end up helping much anyway, but...
That worked. Oh, okay, so... you put that fire out, but it did have a chance to spread to two other fires. And let's... Okay, so you got a little bit more fire going again. And the villagers are looking at you like, ugh, it's been like this all day. They look exhausted.
And do we know why the fire spread? Like, do we know, like, the reason? Like, is it because, like, it's really dry out, or, like, is it really windy? I guess you probably need both conditions.
It's really windy, and it's really dry this year, and there's been fire falling from the sky a lot intermittently for the past, whatever, couple of months, maybe.
Okay.
And I think it was it a Lauren that had a family letter that you weren't sure about? So, yeah. That letter is in another language that you don't recognize.
Okay.
So at this point, I think Kalendor is getting the message that the fires need to be put out. You know, I think he's thinking this will lead to food. So he's going to rush over and using his giant crab claws... kind of like throw up dirt and sand at it, you know? Try to put it out. Just the closest fire.
Okay. Well, the chain quickly shifts over to the new fires. So, go ahead and if you have two characters that are proficient in survival, you can assist and get an advantage.
And is that the standard for help actions? Like, we can only help if we're proficient?
That's the way I've always done it. I think it's rules as written. I think.
Okay.
I'm not a super expert with the 5e rules, and you will find that as a DM... I will often, like, revert back to older rules without intending to. So if there's like, if any of you guys are like rules gurus, then, you know, just feel free to correct me.
Right.
Let's see if that spread. Nope. Wow, you guys are getting lucky on the spread rolls.
A lot of twos.
I know, that's a weird number for to keep rolling for that roll.
I'll move in. I'll try to put out this last fire with the sand. Okay. One and done.
Well, you were getting... Were you getting assisted?
I don't know. I don't think so.
I'm not proficient, so I wasn't. One.
Twist is proficient. She can assist you.
Okay, cool.
Is Axiom Twist or is Axiom Ori?
Axiom is Ori.
Okay. And Twist is the person that's not here, right? Six. Go to St. Louis.
Right. Six. Yes.
Cool.
Okay. So that does it for the fires for the moment. Jacko, the village strong arm, runs up to the party and thanks with air quotes around you, the party. Yeah, great. Okay, now the rock crawlers will have... Oh, sorry, hold on. Yeah, great. Now the rock crawlers will have something more than ash to raid upon their return. They went north after the last raid. They massed somewhere up there. However, the bushfires will continue and are likely to burn more crops at the time when they're needed even more than normal. If there's anything you can do to help, please do so.
We put out fires.
I'm gonna ask what's in it for us.
Well, he just sort of says that and walks away. He's not really trying to start a conversation with you right now.
Well, that's how I prefer it anyway, I guess.
Goodbye, what's in it? What's in it for you is that you get to survive.
I'm definitely going to look into R2 because that one was pretty on fire, and want to see how that what's going on in there now that we've put the fire up.
Yeah, I'm gonna go to the burn victims I saw earlier and try to start addressing their concerns, maybe moving them to where they can get more aid.
Okay, and let me check on... I should probably just leave this character sheet open. And then check on Twist and see. Yes, Twist has medicine as well, so she can help with administering med kits. Oh, that one doesn't fit.
I do maybe like a perception check to see what's in there, or
yeah, go ahead.
Okay. So don't have good perception, but I'm going for it. Mm-hmm.
Dang it, why do you do this to me, you fool? Not you, I'm talking to my music player.
Oh, you're good.
Okay, and what specifically are you looking for?
I mean, the easy answer is food, anything he could, you know, stuff in his mandibles. You know, gold generally is good too, but I'm not trying to be like a pillager necessarily. You know, if I find anybody who's injured, I might sort of like point my claw at them. And I'm sorry, what is Dratar?
What am I? I'm a half orc.
Okay, I'd be like, orc. Look, food? Like, questioningly. Just like, I can eat this?
I mean, I guess. You do you. You can eat that. I think you got the stomach for it.
Lauren would put his arm out and be like, no, not now, Cal.
Did I find anything with my 12?
Nothing super interesting. There isn't much more to scrounge that hasn't already been found. And, mostly it's just like dried up or burned vegetation that you wouldn't eat anyway, even if it wasn't burned up.
I imagine I pick up like a wicker basket or something made out of like grass, and it just falls apart in my hands into ash.
Sorry, what was it that was his name Shaco? What did he say to us?
Jacko, he said he thanked you with air quotes around it. He said, now the rock crawlers will have something more than ash to raid upon their return. They went north after their last raid. They massed somewhere up there. However, the bushfires will continue and are likely to burn more crops at a time when they're even more needed than usual. If there's anything you can do to help, please do so.
And then I get, do we have all the crops handled?
You have all the crops in the village, you know, in the immediate vicinity handled, but you have every reason to expect more fires.
Okay.
So,
is it safe to assume that, like, food is more of an issue for this village than the rock crawlers are?
No. No, it's gonna be the rock crawlers.
Okay.
Not that they can't die of starvation, and probably will, but it'll either be because they've been run through by a bandit, or because they starved because the bandits took all their food.
If we, I'm gonna say to the group, if we go fight these rock crawlers, we might be able to take some of the food that we get back as a reward, or maybe they have some loot.
Did Twist medicine checks heal any villagers?
Yeah, she stabilized a few of them and helped with their.
Okay.
Helped with their burn wounds.
So, Kalendor is definitely going around just tapping things with his claw to watch them turn to ash. And as he does it, he looks at the freshly healed villager and is like, What's a rock crawler?
Rock crawlers are a bandit tribe. The rock crawlers live in mountainous regions mostly, using wyverns to navigate the treacherous bluffs. They have some way of taming and training the wyverns.
Wyvern's like chicken, right?
Wyvern is like a giant chicken with a poisonous stinger.
Or he's like, wyvern. As she starts handing out some of the berries to the starving-looking villagers.
Yeah, probably chiming to the group saying, yeah, going with what Drador said.
Hello?
The rock crawlers probably have more food than we could probably get here. So if we want, we can go after them, come back, and handle whatever fires are still remaining.
Well, I wasn't trying to send you anything.
Maybe ingratiate ourselves with the villagers a bit more.
I agree.
Once you start looking around, these are not all residential. There is a small general store with some basic equipment.
Watching him.
This is a place that sells a few little weapons and armor. If you need any of that, they might have it. Just the basic stuff.
How are the villagers looking at us now? Like, what are their thoughts on us as a group after putting out the fires and healing a few?
Largely, you know, positive or ambivalent. Probably the ambivalent ones are racist against hybrids, and their view is not going to get any better than that. But
okay.
At least if history is any indicator.
Quick question about the group resources mechanic. Does our food spoil?
No, I don't really deal with that.
Okay. Just making sure, like, it's not something that we can't super stock up on. Okay. Cool.
I don't really deal with it. You know, you can just figure it's like hard rations or dried fruit and vegetables or bush tucker.
Okay.
Yeah, after noticing the store, Lauren would probably bring up to the group and ask, is anybody I want to check out the store before we keep hunting up these fires or head north?
Alendor would wander over with you.
What do you say, Orion Trader?
I'll accompany. Definitely don't want to split up right now. Not that they're worrying me, but you know, you never know.
It would not hurt to check it out.
Cool. I didn't see where it was, but I would start heading towards the store.
I think it's the circular building. Well, it's at the south.
Part four. Or did you say, which building did you say it was?
Well, it kind of doesn't really matter, but this is the general store. We can do it pretty much like a menu town anyway. Wait a second. Did I say this one's the general store? I think I did. And this one sells weapons and armor.
Mm.
And this one sells... Well, you'd have to go in there and find out. They sell something. And this one is a tavern inn, but they don't look like they're feeling very festive.
Sure.
So walking by the R7 one, can I make a perception check just to see if I can tell what's in there, if there's any windows or an open door or anything?
Whoa, I forgot it's 4th of July. Go ahead.
So my family is having to go out starting at like 4 with a big giant slide and back to the house.
Yeah, it doesn't look very interesting.
Cool. I would keep walking.
Or you'll be like, what you looking at?
Just seeing what's around here as he's heading his way still towards the weapon store.
I guess Ori will try and see if she could see what he was looking for.
Yeah, and they're, and everyone's real relaxed. They're just having a huge fly.
Looks like not really much of an interesting anything going on in there. It's just kind of a guy sitting at a counter wiping something with a cloth, and sort of disinterested, depressed, like everyone else.
By the way, that's a 24.
I think that's, I don't think there's much more to know with a 24 versus a 15.
Okay. I would definitely want to check out what's in the armor and weapon shop.
Okie dokie. That was a random book. Okay, whatever. They've got a just basically a few long swords, daggers, short swords, crossbows, bows, arrows, some different knives. Few suits of leather, a few suits of hide, one suit of scale mail. But the intense heat is going to be pretty rough on scale mail, so at least for now.
I don't really need anything from this store, but you guys can shop about.
I think I'm good.
Lauren would still take a peek inside just to look around. He would ask what the price of like a light crossbow is and some arrows.
I want to say arrows are 1 gold piece for 10. Crossbow is 25 gold for a light crossbow.
All right, you just continue looking around. And ultimately leave the store without buying anything.
Okay. Just checking out some random stuff online. Okay, so oh, we got a duplicate Drakkar token.
Nope. Did I accidentally do that?
I don't know. I don't know if I did it or if you did it.
I did.
Does Twist actually have an alchemist kit?
An alchemist kit? I am not certain of, but I think she does.
If she doesn't, then I'm going to go ahead and say that Twist was going to buy one. Ari's going to go ahead and buy a herbalist kit, if there's one available.
She does not have an alchemist kit. An alchemist kit is 50 gold. And an herbalist kit is 5 gold. You're putting that in on, you're giving that to Twists.
Well, the herbalist kit is going to Ari, and the alchemist kit will go to Twist if Twist can afford it.
Okay. You want her to pay for it? Okay. She's got the money, well, yes.
Ari only has 5 gold, I think, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, she has the money.
Is Twist just like a party NPC, or is that somebody's player character who's not here?
Somebody's player character, but today is their anniversary.
Oh, okay, that's... okay.
So I'm kind of making sure that his character's prepared for what may come.
Sure, makes sense.
He's like one of my friends from 20 years.
Yeah, that was random because my anniversary is tomorrow.
Happy anniversary.
Thank you. I don't know what we're going to do yet, but I think you're going to go get some coffee and go out to dinner or something. What do you do for an 11th anniversary?
I just celebrated my 10th.
Yeah, the 10th has to be something cool, but then you get to the 11th and you're like, okay, what do we do now?
According to thespruce.com, the traditional 11th anniversary gift is made from strong, durable steel, symbolizing a marital bond.
Yeah, I got close. I got her a ring, but it's not steel. So it's close, though.
Alright, so if everybody's done shopping, Kalendor's gonna look around, snap his claws, and be like, chickens?
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 Do we know if they're bad to eat at all? Or I guess would I know if they're bad to eat at all?
If chickens are bad to eat?
Like the wyverns. Or wyverns.
Oh, wyverns? I don't know. I think you can eat them. You just got to know how to get the poison sac out without getting it on your meat. But if you can do that, I'm sure they're fine to eat.
All right. Yeah, let's go get some chickens then.
Get the chickens.
No disintegrations this time. Okay, so are you guys heading out of town then?
Yeah, sounds like it. You said it was north, right?
Okay, so you're going in the north direction?
Yeah, I think that's where you said they were, or in that direction.
On the way out, Ori's asking Twist if Wyvern is spicy chicken.
Maybe. Maybe it's kind of spicy. So this is a wider scale map, and what I have is I have a party travel icon that I use that actually everybody can control, and you can measure how far you have to go to get wherever you want to get.
Okay, so are we trying to get to the mountain range up there?
There is a road to the north of the mountains, William Agnes Road, which leads up to a bay and if you go far enough north, a few more villages and stuff.
So they said that the rock crawlers were in the mountains to the north, right? Or did I invent that? They said north.
The rock crawlers are massing somewhere to the north, and they tend towards mountains.
Could we have the druid, like, make any type of check to, like, track them? Well, I forget which one's the druid. I don't know if it's Twist or...
No, Twist is an alchemist.
Okay. Oh, duh.
Okay, and I think she has... I said she has proficiency in survival, right? So... Right now, yes, she does. Okay, so she can assist Ori on the survival to give it an 18. And now is a good time for me to show you the standard operating procedures. This is a handout that everybody can edit. So what I'm going to do is, don't all edit it at the same time because that's going to cause hiccups, but let's see, under, this doesn't really fit under anything. We'll go with, actually, I'm going to make a new category under combat tactics. I'm going to make, like, other roles, like skills and stuff. Okay, so, like, oh, come on, what are you doing? Twist will always assist Ori on survival checks. Why isn't that letting me indent? Where's the indent?
Add?
Okay, whatever, screw it. All right. Twist always assists Ori on all survival checks. Okay. So anything like that you don't have to roll for, like, because Twist isn't doing the rolling, Ori is doing the rolling, you can make into a standard operating procedure. Anything that basically, like, marching, like you see marching order, watch order, combat formations and stuff like that, any kind of quirks or habits. And if you want to define any spell component collection habits, you just can't, like, it can't cost any money and it can't involve a dice roll. But that's there just to define, like, stuff that you are doing as standard procedure so you don't have to always say it.
What would be an example of the spell component collection habits?
Every time you enter an area with bats, you're going to pick up some bat guano for your fireballs. Anytime you are, you know...
Yeah, in area X, get Y kind of thing.
Yeah, pretty much.
Cool.
I mean, I guess you could just really say anytime I'm around a free spell component, I'll pick it up. But whatever.
Yeah, can I put that for me?
yeah. So you can say, like, anything that looks vaguely interesting or just at random, I pick it up. Like, like the Kender from Dragonlance, but, you know, you'll just end up with weird, stupid things. So I thought that would be a good opportunity to bring that up, just so you guys know about it.
I mean, as far as marching order, I don't think Kalendor would necessarily be the leader. Like I said before, he's kind of sort of a goon. But, you know, if somebody else wanted to lead, he would be, like, probably second, you know, kind of.
I'm down to kick ass as the first person in marching order. I think I can take some, you know, take some damage and do some damage as well.
I was thinking with the possibility of putting the druid towards the front for, like, tracking purposes, since sure. I feel like a lot of what we do may do that, so whether it's one or two, doesn't matter to me.
I guess it would depend on the situation.
Yeah, that's
so true. The druid would definitely be in front if she was needed for, you know, tracking. But in other situations, you know, like, we'll let someone with a little more armor class take the lead.
Yeah, could we put, like, a conditional marching order?
Yep.
Like, if tracking, it's Ori. If we're not tracking, it's Dredar.
We'll put so this is tracking. So Ori, Dredar, Kalendor, I don't know, Aloran, and that would put Twist at the back, which is just rear point, of course, as we all know.
Kalendor being in the middle actually isn't bad, because no matter which way they get attacked, Kalendor's going to run towards the attacker. Like, he likes to hit things. So. Or pinch things. Whack things.
He likes to watch as the lights go out.
Yeah. Yeah, he does. Okay, so, you guys did a survival check with advantage, and we got an 18, right?
Correct. All right.
It's going to be rough, because Kalimdor for me will always be the sword that is not a sword.
Oh, is that a thing, Kalimdor? I just came up with it because I think it's Alanis, maybe, is the genus name of the blue crab.
No, it's not a bad name.
So sure enough, your tracks are leading north.
I guess I'll start while the druid would be helping us track. So I guess I'll suggest we start marching north if they've made it verbal to the group.
Yeah, I'll be pointing the way and, you know, whatever tricks I need to use.
Okay, so that's, what, 5 or 10 miles?
Well, it'll be a 5 mile for you, so, to get to this one.
Okay. So what's that take, like 2 hours?
No, it's 2 hours if you're moving slowly and carefully.
Yeah, I would just be following the lead of whatever Ori's doing, so.
Boy, these are a lot of fails right now.
I mean, we're not trying to sneak up on these guys, per se. We just want to know where they're at, right?
Yeah.
Because you have to tell Ori that you want to be sneaky.
I think we're just trying to find out where they are. I don't think we're trying to, like, sneak up on them or anything.
I mean, outside of water, sneaky, Calendar is not very sneaky, so.
I was going to say we have a giant crab.
Shiny red glistening shell.
He's very shiny.
Carapace that blazes like the sun.
He might have ate his mother.
He never knew his mother.
But he bets she would have been delicious.
Say, as we're walking, Kalindor's like, not a lot of rats in Rat Village. Disappointing.
You expected more rats?
Rats are good eat. Protein.
Yes, I see.
So how many good berries would you say I handed out in, you know, the village?
How many did you want to hand out? You didn't mention it.
It says up to 10 in the spell.
I did say I would hand them out to anyone who looked starving. I don't think anyone heard me, though.
Oh, it must have gotten lost in the noise or something, because I didn't catch it. I would say as many as you want, really, but you wouldn't need more than about 30 or 40 if you want to do that many.
Oh, I was making 10.
Oh, okay. Gotcha.
I have 2 spell slots. I used one of them.
Oh, 10, 10 for the 10 most in need.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So the answer would be all of them, then.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can keep it going as long as you want. They'll be able to use all that stuff.
Kalindor's definitely got a good berry at the end of one of his claws, and he's just kind of nomming on it as we walk. It's kind of like a slurping sound as he chews away at it with his weird crab teeth. There is some crab teeth. They're crazy.
The tracks continue north into the mountains. You're in the foot of the mountains and looking up a slope that goes off into the horizon and into the distance. It's not really that steep. It's just kind of a walk uphill, mostly.
Are we getting close, do you think?
Make a... investigation check, and if anybody is proficient in it, if two people are proficient in it, one can assist the other.
I'm proficient in it, so I'll assist.
Okay, let me check on it.
Well, I'm not proficient with it, so I'm not going to roll.
I'll roll it unless if anyone else is.
Twist is proficient as well. So she can roll and you can assist her if you want.
And we can put that in our SOPs.
Yeah, you can do that.
Look at that.
These tracks are probably anywhere from 3 to 5 days old.
Can we tell how many there are by the tracks?
It's kind of hard to say for sure from the tracks, but from the reports from the villagers, it sounded like there were somewhere in the ballpark of a dozen or so. And the tracks don't contradict that. Sometimes, they're on wyverns, so they're gonna be airborne at times. So,
okay. Anyone have a problem if we keep moving forward?
No.
Nope.
Yep. I mean, we've been going for how long so far?
That's a good question.
It's been a couple hours, maybe. It's not been that long. So right now it's pretty close to noon and getting into the hottest part of the day.
What's the landscape look like around us right now if we're not at the mountain yet?
Well, you're at the foot of the mountain, so if you're looking north at mountains, west and east, you're looking at more or less just flatlands, out back, mostly desert, but some bush. Like, there would normally be more bush than there is, but right now there's just not. Like, it's not growing this year, or it's growing very poorly.
Ari's probably gonna, like, how bright is it out?
It's not, there isn't any clouds at all, so it's
great direct sunlight.
Yeah. What happened to my...
The landscape, is it rocky at all, or just straight up frickin' like savanna?
Well, it's kind of badlands. Like, you're gonna get kind of a blend of rocky sand and dirt and savanna. What vegetation is still growing here is
Maybe there's some steps or something. Like, I'm looking for a place where a cave might exist.
Are there any sort of, like, pride rock style outcropping?
Make a perception check.
I can assist with that, too, if I see him looking.
26.
You can see kind of in a northeast direction that there are some some signs of some kind of, like, activity, like, parts of the landscape that are manicured and stuff, and where there, you know, ledges and outcroppings where there could be a cave and things of that nature.
All right, I'm gonna ask the group if they want to continue on the trail after the wyverns, or if they want to wait out the heat of the day. Ari's definitely getting a little bit on the weary side.
Yeah, crabs don't have sweat glands, so, Kalendor would be in favor of taking a rest under the possible shade of a cave.
Or he refrains from bringing up the cliche about a crab boiling in a pot.
You do in fact find a cave to cool off in and have a siesta for the afternoon. So we can do a short rest and we can call it 4 p.m. So, and it is still, this is a winter month too, by the way. It is still winter, so it's the tail end of winter, but, you know, by 4 p.m. the sun is getting low and it's getting pretty cool. By the time
this is winter, I'd hate to see summer.
Well, this is an unseasonably hot year already, and predictions are it's gonna get hotter. The planet has a wobbly orbit more than, you know, is normal because of the gods striking it with lightning as punishment during the dark times. It set the planet on a more pronounced wobble than what you would expect. So it can, like, it'll, like, the seasons have about a 7-year rotation, and they can, you know, you can have places where you would expect to be hot that they're cold, and maybe even snowy once every 7 years, and then you can have places that you would expect to be cold that are hot, or at least warm once every 7 years.
Okay. I think we're probably good to continue, right?
No, I think we should set up a settlement here, you know?
Like camp?
Yeah, we can continue.
I'm ready to continue as well.
Ditto.
Yeah, okay, cool. Okay, I was just double checking. Everybody should have ownership of the party travel icon, so everybody should be able to move it around hypothetically. You see what is a small village, and by small, I mean two things. I mean, one, the size of the village is small in that it's only got a few shops and just a few dwellings and a couple little, you know, this is and that's, but it's really not much to it. And also small in that the size of the structures is all kind of unusually small.
How small are we talking? Are we talking like minish small, or are we looking like a gnome small?
Kind of around this, somewhere between a halfling and a dwarf.
Okay.
So about the size of Twist.
Mm-hmm.
Do we see people?
No. In fact, you don't see anyone around. You don't see any fires burning. But you do quickly notice that there are some scorched materials here and there, and a few things smoldering here and there.
Anyone want to look inside the dwellings?
Yeah, I'll go with Kalendor.
I think Twist would probably be intrigued a little bit by the size of the village investigate as well.
You come across an unconscious wombat hybrid, and they are lying on the ground. So, Twist has medicine proficiency. I don't know who else does, but she has medicine proficiency as well as... I'm gonna give you control of her so that you can play her in Six's absence.
Also give Six control of Ari.
Okay. Okay, there's Twist, and I'll put Six's name on Ari. Cool. All right. So yeah, you come across an unconscious wombat hybrid. They seem to be, well, they're not conscious, anyway. They seem to have sustained some kind of an injury. All right. I think there was a medicine. Anybody else proficient in medicine?
Not me.
I am not.
Okay.
Kalendor will happily, you know, smack it on the chest, hoping that'll wake it up or restart its heart.
On Twist's character sheet, there's under the core tab, if you scroll down to class resources, there's Tinker's Fury of the Small, and then I put one in there for Healer's Kit. So she has two Healer's Kits, which means 20 uses. Yeah. Okay. So a failed check is still an expended use, but
What does Fury of the Small do? Doesn't that give you advantage on? It's damage. Never mind.
So I think Fury of the Small is really good with stuff like Magic Missile and Eldritch Blast and Shocking Grasp and stuff like that. Or Fireball.
Is this the rat that was missing from Rat Village?
It is not. Do you want Ori to try, or Twist to try again?
I mean, can Ori use a spell to heal it?
Yeah, you can do that too, yeah.
I mean, we're gonna sit here and, you know, we had a rest, or I'll probably need a long rest to be able to get my spells back, but I'll throw up another good berry and, you know, provide it a good berry. And everyone else in the party, I guess, so that we have rations for today.
Can you give a good berry to an unconscious character?
You can put it in the mouth and, you know, make it chew it. Or you can bait this will run down the throat.
You could dice it up and just drop the dice berries into their mouth. Flatter it and make like a...
Do the reverse Heimlich maneuver. Instead of pushing on the stomach, you pull on it.
There you go. Now you're thinking.
It looks like the answer to that question is no.
All right, well...
It's possible to administer a potion, but it is not possible to administer a good berry because the spell states that the creature has to use an action to consume the berry, and an unconscious creature cannot use an action.
Could an alchemist make a potion out of a good berry?
Probably. But well, in the time that she takes to make the potion, the person will die.
All right, well then I guess I'll just cast healing cure wounds on him.
Okay. All right, cool. Perfect. They open their eyes and kind of they're looking around for a minute and just they look disoriented and sort of relieved, like they just survived a car accident, but they don't know who you are, and they don't know what's going on.
The first face they see is Kalendor.
Kalendor slams his claws under the ground and gets real close with his face. He goes, "Huh?"
He's looking very terrified and kind of recoiling back and scooting back on the rocks.
Kalendor is pleased.
Lauren probably asks, what happened here? What is this place?
He just scrambles up to his feet and runs towards, he runs over to the east, which appears to be in the direction of the aforementioned.
By the way, Ori is also scrambling away back on her hands and feet as well.
Okay. She's running towards he's running towards the village in fear.
Wait, Ori is running away from Kalendor, or?
The person that you just revived is running away from you in fear because Kalendor slammed his fists down and made mean faces at him.
I'm because what's it called? Ari just said that they were also afraid.
Oh, Ari is doing whatever Axiom wants her to do, but
that's my question.
I mean, Ari just freaking, you know, laid her hands on the person, right? They woke up and Kalendor walks up, slams his hands on the ground and starts yelling.
What a friendly guy.
Hey, dude.
I would say you kind of scared the hell out of her.
I do have proficiency in intimidate.
Ari will notice the person running away and kind of start to give chase, saying, "Hey, wait a minute. We just want to know what happened."
And Lorna would do something along the same lines, asking, like, "Please, we just want to talk."
I'm going to remain silent because I don't like strangers, so.
Kalendor is going to turn to Dratar and be like, "Did I do something wrong?"
You know, buddy, maybe, but I don't think so.
Me either.
As they're running towards the village and Ori is behind them, behind him, I'm sorry, you see that he's talking to another hybrid wombat and kind of gesturing towards you in a panic sort of way, and the other one seems a little more level-headed and not quite so skittish and jumpy.
Or he's going to let the one that's freaking out have a space then, because there's someone else to talk to.
Yeah, I was going to ask Ori if she wanted to talk to, if they want to talk to the more level-headed wombat.
The other one has, you noticed, a staff and some, what's the word I'm looking for? Important-looking robes and some jangly things. Kind of some regalia.
Some jangly things?
Yeah, a necklace and some stuff coming off the robes and the garb and stuff.
Or he's a little bit distracted by that.
Does Twist or anyone else have a have religion?
I have
proficiency.
I believe. Yeah, I have proficiency in religion. Would I be able to make a check to see if I know what anything he has means?
Yeah.
Shaking off the mild distraction, or he's going to be like, don't mind my large friend. He's a bit of a dope.
Way
back.
Okay. So, yeah, this is an Aboriginal shaman, probably for this, what appears to be a tribe of wombats. And this is probably the elder shaman of the village. And it looks like they're carrying a totem and wearing the traditional, shaman devices. There isn't a whole lot more you know about it than that, other than it's probably a divine caster of some kind.
When they were running, were we by the village and they ran away from it? Are we still like in the village vicinity?
You were maybe, I don't know, 500 yards west of the village.
Okay.
And so they booked it to the village, and now Jetta is approaching you in a with a friendly mannerism, like not like threatening or anything.
Lauren would ask if they know anything about the rock dwellers or the location that they're at.
She believes that they are a couple hundred miles north, maybe. But she isn't really sure. They never seem to notice the wombats for some reason. They've learned to hide from them. They pass through periodically, going between their hideout HQ and some different places that they raid on the regular. She introduces herself as Jetta. She is the head elder of the Wombat Bureau. Burrow, I'm sorry, not Bureau. And the leader of the Wombat Council.
I would introduce myself.
I imagine they have a very bureaucratic society.
Thank you. All right, let's... We got to keep that one going. I hate bureaucracies. Well, thank you, Ori, for introducing yourself. I guess, Twist will introduce herself as well. The rest of you are just Philistines, apparently.
I introduced myself.
Well, I introduced the crab, too.
I'm still learning everybody's voice. I thought I was hearing, when Parius was talking, I thought I was hearing Axiom.
Oh,
so,
okay.
Yeah. So, Aloran introduced himself.
I said, please don't mind me and my large topi friend. And he said, hi.
She just seems amused. Not wildly amused, but just kind of, whatever. She's not concerned about it.
Kalendor is going to kind of trundle up to her and like you see his eye stalks kind of squint, and he's like, did a wizard make you? he recognizes another hybrid.
Nobody made me. I was born. Everyone in this village was born. This is a little bit of a revelation for you, if she's telling the truth, because that shouldn't be possible. But there are some races that somehow, either spontaneously or by design, got the ability to reproduce.
I think Kalendor is a little like, whoa.
Or he's like, what's it like to be born?
Yeah.
I don't really remember,
she says.
I'm gonna ask how long their village has been here.
Oh, been here at least 100 generations or so. Yeah, my father.
And you speak Australian? Father.
Yeah, mate.
Sorry.
The council borough is in a state of organized chaos as you arrive. There's a lot of coming and going, which seems to be centralized over the village.
We get any type of, like, disdain towards us from them?
No, they completely like you. So, okay. They've got a positive first impression of you, and they're not going to be racist against hybrids. You know?
Yeah.
Even if they are scary.
I think Alora would ask what's going on and like why everything's so, like everyone's in and out or running around, I guess.
And the bushfires that have been raging for the past few days have become unmanageable and dangerous. The surface dweller has been caught off guard, and some are seeking refuge within our burrows. If something can't be done, many lives and livelihoods will be lost. Elder Jeddah and the Wombat Council want you to gather as many willing villagers and surface dwellers as you can and lead them back to the burrow safely. Some may need to be convinced as to why the burrow is the safest option for them, but they stress that you should not resort to violence.
So, I would ask Jeddah how far the burrow is, or how far away the burrow is.
I think I'm going to double check, but I think it's like right under your feet. Let me make sure I'm...
So when you say surface dwellers, do you mean the villagers from like Rat Village?
Just anybody walking around on the surface, so.
Underneath the burrows. I say we leave a breadcrumb trail. You know, ooh, piece of candy.
This village consists, by the way, of a council... A few modest homesteads. Surface dwellers do live here. And they have an inn and a tavern, as well as several craftsmen workshops and a few shops, and so on. You're welcome to set up a home here if you wish. So,
I'll say that breadcrumb thing is definitely how Kalendor started following you guys.
I think the entrance to the under Heath Burrow is where the majority of the small wombat community work and live. Their elaborate tunnel system consists of several homesteads, a communal kitchen, a council borough, a farming warden, and a multitude of different craft areas.
So wait, they have a council, so they are bureaucrats.
Exactly.
Oh, that is the best.
We'll get back on how to get there. We'll get back to you.
Alorna would ask why wants everybody to, like, or everyone to go into these burrows. Like, what does she think is the benefit of this?
It's underground. Their food isn't burning. They have water. They have shelter from the fires and from the hot, temperatures.
Fair enough.
And the bandits don't go there. They don't seem to know about it. God forbid they ever find out about it. But they probably wouldn't be that interested anyway. It's just a bunch of wombats. They do express some concern for the normies and surface dwellers around, that, they want them to be safe.
Lauren would turn to the group and ask, like, what do you guys think? Should we help Jedi out?
Calendar, we should help them. This problem seems a little more immediate than the one from the village to the south. Maybe. But I think helping out as many of the villagers here as we can is something that we need to do.
So I think Kalendor is in favor of helping hybrid people. But, he also is looking forward to a fight and some chicken. So I think he would say, if we find people on the way, we tell them about Burrow.
That's fair.
If you give me the evening, I can go looking out for some of them tonight. When the sun starts going down.
This is a smaller scale map. You can see the hexes are about a half mile each, I think. Oh, I love that.
Zoom and enhance. They have a tiny wombat church?
I don't think they do church exactly with the tribalistic kind of aboriginal shaman worship style is probably more kind of like naturalistic, and
you could be more of a town hall with a bell tower for warning purposes
for the bureaucrats.
This is giving me red wall vibes.
Ooh, I don't know red wall.
You don't know red wall? Gasp.
No, I don't.
It's a children's book series that's worth, like, learning about. But, we can take the day to try to look for people for the borough if that's what people want to do, and then there's always half a chance the rock crawlers could come back this way, heading back towards the Rad Village to raid it again.
I, I'm interested in helping the wombat people, so I'm game to send people to the burrow.
Now, the burrow has secret tunnels that lead down to the river, where flotilla boats are waiting. Once everyone is accounted for, we intend to use the waterways to take everyone to safety.
River means water. Water is good for crabs. I'm in.
Yeah. How big are these tunnels? I'm a large guy. I'm a half orc. You know, I can't just be crawling down.
You'll be okay.
Okay.
The water's good. Our friend is just starting to get a little salty.
I turn to Dratar and just wave my claw in front of my face. Like, I'm assuming he's not talking about me. Okay. All right, so, can we roll something to look for people, or what,
Well, a good place to start might be to the east of the village, where some of the nearby farmsteads are.
Uh-huh.
That could be a good choice.
Okay. I'll go look there. How much daylight do we have left, would you say?
Your daylight is out. It is, let's see, it's about 8 o'clock, and all you've got left is just a faint glow of twilight in the distant horizon that will be gone in about 20 minutes, and it'll be pitch black.
All right. Well, Ari decides to go straight up Owl and take off into the east and start looking from the skies.
I guess the Lauren stays behind then.
Alandor is going to look at the owl flying away, and he's like, Ari is chicken. But we'll really follow along.
He kind of looks at Kalimdor like, crab legs. Big crab legs.
Come try to take them.
Yeah, I'm going to stay in the village with Alorn.
Hey, can we, like, search the... I do, too, so I don't know if we can just, like, search the immediate area out to where we think is safe to see if anyone's around.
You can do it that way if you want. Let's see.
What kind of checks do you want Ari to make from the sky?
Why don't you guys do... You can do an investigation check. You can do it assisted as long as there's... I think we figured out more than one person is proficient in investigation. Twist has a, +6 on her roll.
Yeah, I'm also proficient in investigation.
I am not, and I don't think we want me rolling for investigation, but I can be here for moral support.
I was about to say, oh, why do I smell smoke? Oh, right, fireworks. Is my house on fire? No, it's fireworks.
Do you need a Lauren to make investigation roll? Because Ari's, like, in the air, right?
Yeah, well, I mean, Ari can come back and, you know, tell you where she sees possible places to investigate. And then, you know, people who have, you know, charisma scores can go try and find them and talk them into coming.
Okay, and it's Lauren, assisting Ori on investigation, is that right?
That would be Lauren assisting Twist.
Twist, that's what I meant to say.
Did we ever get the sodas inside?
Ainsley?
You run into some overgrown terrain that is difficult to pass. You will have to make a... All of you that are trying to go through it will have to make a DC 12 strength saving throw or turn back.
So right now, is it that, like, Ori's flying, like, one direction and the rest of us are... like around the perimeter around this, or
I heard around the perimeter, so that's what I thought. That's what I thought was being investigated.
Yeah, I think that's what we're doing. I just didn't know where, like, if Ori was like above us, or if she's like, or if they're like in a going the opposite direction.
Ori's overwatch.
I don't think so.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
If I may be of service, click, click.
We've got a crab with a couple of bushwhackers for hands.
Yeah, to be honest, he could probably just cut it up and rip it up.
So yeah, I'm going to clip it, you know, with my big old clippers. Kind of throw it out the way and make the path clear for everyone.
Lauren would follow behind.
Oh, we can't do that. We can't do that. Okay. Everybody give me an initiative roll.
Can we get characters to select? Or you're just going to have to enter all of our turns?
Neither of the above. Okay, so Twist
completely failed.
Twist is the only one that doesn't have initiative. You've uncovered a Tasmanian devil that jumps out from under the vines and tries to bolt for it. It would make a good meal if you wanna try to snatch it real quick or survival check it or whatever you want to do and use it as a night's food.
I'll try to snatch it out of the air.
Okay.
What kind of, would that be an athletics check or acrobatics if I try to leap for it, I guess?
I was thinking more of an attack roll.
Oh, an attack roll? Okay. Yeah. Then I guess I'll swing my club at it. I don't think that hits.
Hang on a sec. Okay. You don't have to do /R1d20. You can click on Great Club on your character sheet, and it'll give you the roll along with the damage.
Gotcha. Okay.
So it'll take into account your strength and your proficiency and stuff.
Okay.
So that whacks it pretty good and pre-tenderizes the meat a little bit. So Kalendor can go after that. I imagine you're probably going to grab at it with your pincers.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see here.
Okay. Yep, okay. So you're good. So you can eat that tonight and skip the use of your food on hand. Speaking of which, it is probably time to call it a night and take a long rest and continue on in the morning, I think. They will let you sleep if you want to, like, just anywhere you want for free. I mean, not in people's houses, but pretty much anywhere you want for free. Or you can get a room at the inn if you want, if you want to pay a few gold for something a little nicer.
Crabs are known to burrow.
Yeah, and they do that. Sand flinging thing, like they flip the sand all over the place while they're burrowing.
Yeah, I mean, I'm down to just sleep outside. No need to pay for a room.
I like a firm mattress. Earth is pretty firm.
I remember going to burrow at night.
Because, well, I figured, you know, owl eyes are good at spotting people at night.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we were about to do a long rest, but you said if we get this Tasmanian devil, we could use it as food for the night.
Yeah, that doesn't interfere with your long rest or anything. You know,
the crab tort, you know.
My Tasmanian devil.
That doesn't interfere with your long rest.
Okay, so
I don't think we started our long rest, that's all.
I remember discussing where we were all going to sleep, so.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah, I think that was the implication, was that we were choosing our spots for the long rest.
I'm guessing we did not find any villagers.
While you were sleeping? You did not?
Yeah, the prior to the sleeping where we caught the food.
But yeah, you're, you are waking back up the next day. We'll call it 7 a.m. So the sun will be coming up in about an hour or so.
Okay, so is everybody on the same page that we should go look for villagers for Jetta?
Yeah, I think we all agreed on that.
Yeah, I'm down to spread our search out more now that, you know, we have one more daylight, or just more hours to find more people.
Okay. Cool. Well, so we checked eastward last time, and that, I guess we didn't get far enough, like, we didn't get to the farmlands at all?
No, I understood that you checked the perimeter last time, probably something along this line.
Okay. Well, they said there was farmland out east.
Yeah.
So, I'm gonna point a big old claw, you know, towards the sunrise and say, let's look over there.
Sure, Lauren follows.
Yeah, I'll follow as well.
Okay, and any of you can control the party travel icon, so You can just grab it and start moving it.
I just realized I am in the ruler and not the... But yeah.
Doesn't hurt to measure, too.
Measure twice, move once?
Yes.
All right, so I moved us to the farm. And do any of us see farmers or other people?
You see, at the moment, several farms and orchards, as well as some smaller homesteads around the area. And you can see some of the farmers working their way around the area. A couple of you, especially for those who are maybe a little more perceptive, notice that there is some kind of ruckus a little further off to the east. You can hear probably some hollering and some kind of general commotion. And
I'd like to move over to the sound and investigate.
Yeah,
Kalendor motion or just emotion, you know, because of the bureaucracy.
There's some kind of motion. Oh, no, you're making a joke. I get it.
Motion
to move eastward. All in favor?
Aye.
Ears.
Pigs!
Okay, so this is already... I'm not sure what I have for this, but go ahead and put your characters on the... there we go, that works. Your characters on the field, wherever you want them to be.
You just drag the characters over?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a little finicky, though, just so you know, you have to select it right on the name, which is... I don't know why. I don't know why they do it that way, but for whatever reason, like, if you grab, like, the sandwich menu and try to drag it over, it's not going to work. Okay, so get in a starting position and just hold there for a moment.
I take a little bit of point.
You've got a farmer kind of running around frantically trying to calm his flock of goats. Is it a flock? I think it's a flock.
Herd of goats. Flock of sheep, herd of goats.
So a farmer is running around trying to calm his herd of goats and get them wrangled up.
Okay.
I'm gonna yell at the farmer. Would you like any help?
He kind of has this, like, crazy prospector vibe sort of thing. Why, yes, you gotta get these guys wrangled up.
Do we see, like, an empty pen or anywhere that they might go?
Well, all you really need to do is, among the group, you have to make three checks, and they can either be animal handling or intimidation.
Ooh, intimidation.
And you can also use athletics as well. So any of those, and you can roll those. There, it's a little bit high of a DC. So
anybody else intimidating?
Yeah, I have some intimidation.
I got plus four.
Yeah, I think I plus six. Yeah.
Psst. Oh, then I will help you.
So I'm gonna move over to this goat, and see if it's a fainting goat, and try to scream at it to see if it'll faint and be intimidated.
I'm gonna pop out behind him with my claws clackling.
Okay.
Not good enough.
Goats are notoriously hard to shake.
Welcome back, Aloran. We're trying to wrangle some goats.
Oh, cool.
You'll have to drag your character onto the field, I guess, from the character sheet or character list. Okay.
Probably not there. We can probably...
Anywhere's fine. Cool. Yeah, it's not real specific on this one.
So I tried to intimidate a goat and it didn't work. I can guess if Calendar wants to try, I'll assist him.
All right, well, then I'm going to step up towards the goat. I'm going to slam my claws into the ground and go, bah! Like a goat would go.
Okay. Good to go.
I got the goat?
Yep, okay, we need one more.
Got the goat's goat.
What about Aloran?
I'm still trying to figure out what's going on.
We're wrangling up these goats. They're spooked and they're running around. The farmer's trying to get them wrangled up.
Gotcha. And then I will start over here. Are these stairs? I don't know how to ping. Are these stairs?
Yeah, it's a barn.
Okay. Oh, this is probably where they need to be.
Yeah, those two goats are already in there.
Makes sense. Okay.
Or maybe this is the barn. I'm not quite sure. It's kind of low res, but you know, it doesn't matter too much for this encounter.
In the box.
Mm-hmm.
I'll try to make an animal handling check for this one.
Naughty goats go in the fear box.
Oh, this is going to go too well, but you never know. Damn it.
Is that something that Twist might have been able to help with?
Nope.
All right, I'm gonna...
Twist is absolutely useless in this encounter.
I'm gonna move up to the goat again, and I'm gonna try my intimidation again. I've gone back to the drawing board, and I've re-orchestrated my scream. I'm gonna try again.
Does a 16 animal handling check on this guy get him in? Or do you need me to roll, or did I go out of turn or something?
Nope, you're good. That's all the checks I need.
So Ari is leading the animals in calmly while Kalindor and Dratar are just running around screaming at them.
Yeah, Alred's trying to just like shoo them into the barn.
You know, several ways to skin a cat.
Yeah. You know, all three of you
are talking about skinning cats.
I've got them all walking behind me.
Does anyone have a cat? Cat's delicious.
I'm looking at y'all like, what are you yelling at?
We got the goats in.
All right.
They faint.
So the farmer thanks you for your kind service and says you're welcome to stay there and she does have a little bit of food to spare if you want any food and water.
Kalendor is going to take that as a cue to just kind of dunk his head into the pig trough.
She's like, that works.
You see little bubbles coming up.
Malorn will gladly take the food and say thank you to the farmer. I say take the food, obviously, I mean for the whole group, not just for me.
I'd like to ask the farmer what they know about the wombat people. Or are they wombat people themselves?
They're mostly wombat people at this farm, yeah. They grow food for the village. They send most of their food over to the village.
Okay, I'm gonna ask if they're aware of Jetta. Is that was her name?
Of course, she is the village elder. Whatever.
She has this plan. I don't know how well you're gonna like it with your animals, but it'd be to use the tunnels to go down to the waterway and get on a boat. And I'm like trying to use persuasion to like make it sound like a good idea that, you know, it's you know, the best thing to do with the you know, the fires and the rock crawlers.
Okay, roll a persuasion check.
All right.
Okay.
Well, they started the fireworks late this year.
We didn't start the fire.
Sorry. So she is going to wrangle up her herd and head towards the burrows in that case. And that is one down.
Can I grab a pig?
Yeah.
Where did you go?
She can give you a pig.
Nice. Add that to our food.
Are one of us just carrying this pig around then for the whole time?
Sounds that way.
It can be under Kalimdor's arm.
Don't chop it.
Probably, I'm going to guess that you're going to slaughter it when you get out of sight of the farmer.
I mean, I have a certain, you know, respect for another scavenger, but yes.
I don't think you can carry this pig. Or at least not all of it.
I have an 18 strength.
It's not letting me. There we go. Come on. Oh yeah, you're over your carrying capacity. You're carrying a 300-pound pig. Let's see. If we cut it in half, let's see what happens.
Has it officially been slaughtered yet?
Well, we've cut it in half now, so I'm going to say yes.
Okay.
150 pounds, and you are no longer over capacity. So you can maybe see if anybody else wants to carry the other half, or just dump it, or I don't know what.
Don't we have mounts? Wasn't there a thing about us getting mounts?
Yes, you do. You have mounts. Everybody has one. So really, you can just have them carry it anyway. I just wasn't thinking about that.
Yeah, I'm going to put it on the back of my hermit crab shell and continue.
Okay, you can delete that.
From my feet.
That pig off your equipment sheet. And I am going to... This wasn't a blank blue sheet. One moment, please, bear with me. Still got this and that startup stuff, you know. It's probably going to come up here and there.
Sure.
Okay, so this is a character sheet that everybody has access to, and it's just called Group Loot, Equipment, Rations, and so on. So it's group, you know, possessions that maybe, you know, usually they haven't been assigned yet or divided up or whatever. And that's what this character sheet is for. You don't have to define who's carrying everything necessarily right away, but you know, eventually it shouldn't sit on this sheet for ages and ages, ideally, but you know, whatever you gotta do.
Yeah, I mean, I imagine this pig will probably be you know, quickly devoured. Yeah,
I figured it was already added to, you know, our rations.
It's a little different because it's 300 pounds of fresh pig meat. And it's not, it's going to go bad before you can consume it all. So,
well, it's a good thing we've got starving, you know, villagers around us.
Yeah, that's what I was going to suggest, is maybe have a pig roast in the village.
Okay, so I was going to suggest, since nobody's using that farm anymore, we make jerky.
Sure.
But, you know, pig roast is good, too. Yeah.
Sure, yeah. I mean, whatever you want to do.
Perfect. I mean, making jerky's going to take a whole rest of the day. At least several days, maybe.
All right, so do we want to keep looking on the farms and see if there's any more people to
recruit? Let's ask our farmer if she knows where any of the other people are. Would be my guess.
Well, you should see a number of farmsteads around the farming area. She tells you there's 5 of them. So you can just go check on the farmers and see what they're up to. And if they are interested in going underground.
Is anyone more persuasive than the giant crab man?
Probably the paladin.
Who's the paladin?
I don't know. I thought there was a paladin.
I don't think we have a paladin.
I have some persuasion. I have +4.
Maybe that's what Mune was going to do. +4 isn't too bad. You could do worse.
I could scare people into a hole. That's about all I got.
I say we just let the monk do the persuading in the next few places.
Yeah, I'll take persuasion lead.
Yeah, my persuasion's a flat 0.
So, which the farms are to the east?
Yeah, they're kind of around. You sort of passed one on your way to the where you heard the ruckus, but for the most part, the bulk of them are to the east.
Okay, we could probably hit that first one on the way back. I'd say let's move on to the next farm if we're ready.
Let's do it.
Okay, as you continue east, you can hear a roaring and screaming sound as a mass of fire swirls into view.
It's a fire. Can we tell what's on fire?
Well, it's kind of in this area. Probably one of the things.
Buildings? Barns.
Farms is what I'm trying to say.
Is there anything we can do to actually help?
Well, as you approach, you can see farmers trying to rapidly save their crops from a fiery tornado. They're gathering crops, quickly yanking them off the vine as fast as they can.
Do we see anything around to put the fire out?
No.
Well.
How big is the fire tornado?
Right now it's just maybe 20 feet wide at the most. And so about half the size of a fireball, and it goes up about 40 or 50 feet in the air.
I don't know if this is too meta, but would I be able to cast, like, absorb elements on it?
Maybe.
You can only cast absorb elements on yourself.
If I cast myself, I put my hand in it, would it absorb it and, like, destroy the fire?
Well, if you click on the spell, which is usually how I have people cast spells, it will pop into the chat, and we can look at it and figure that out.
Doesn't really work that way, but it's a good idea.
Do I just have to say, like, actually cast a spell to see the stuff, or?
No. I mean, you could just look at it.
Okay. Oh, I think I need to do it from the spell list.
to be.
Did you look at me with a horse look?
There we go. Okay.
Sir, you're slumber.
Okay, so.
I feel like even if it somehow did work, I don't think it would stop the fire.
It looks like mainly it gives you resistance against fire.
Okay.
That's the main thing, which of course isn't going to hurt anything, but it's not going to do anything to...
Yeah, there's no reason to do it. Does anyone have any ideas to try to put this fire out?
You're not going to be able to. There's no water. There's no sand. Well, no, I should take that back. There might be a way. Like, somebody might have a spell that'll do it or something that'll do it, but there's no water and there's no sand anyway.
I'm gonna start running alongside and grabbing crops off the vine to try to save as many as possible.
I see him do that, and I do it too.
What kind of crops are they? Are they like corn, or are we talking like grapes, or what's on a vine?
Let's find out. Wheat, canola, oats, pulses, barley, different vegetables and fruits, so... The fruits aren't doing so well this year.
So can I use my pincers to like go down? I assume they're on some sort of trellis.
They're just planted in rows in the ground.
Okay. I was gonna say, I wanted to like cut one end of the rope or the vine and throw it away from the fire. You know what I mean? So that I could say
you could try and create a stopgap. You know, an area where there's the fire can't spread to anywhere else.
I was thinking about that, but I don't think I could conceivably create a 20-foot long stopgap in enough time that I would outspeed the fire.
A couple of the farmers toss you guys baskets and seem to indicate that you could just grab what you can and put it in the basket.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'd probably end up doing that.
Yeah,
I'm gonna grab as much as I can and put it in the basket.
Yeah, I'm gonna do it at a run, doing a speed grab, just grabbing as many as I can row by row.
I'm just running my pincer along the vine. Running all the way down the row, you know, like when you pull something off a string, like it's like popcorn on a string or something, and you stretch it out.
Okay. After a round or two, you all have a couple of full baskets, and a smoke method appears.
Do you think this would be able to kind of help create a fire gap?
I don't really think so.
I think it would have to, you know, quickly disintegrate the acid fast enough, or the plant matter fast enough, that the fire couldn't spread to it.
I was thinking the thing, you know, kills everything within a 5-foot line for 30 feet, so.
The crop lines are longer than 30 feet.
Right, but how big is the twister?
You said it was 20 feet.
It's about 20 feet wide by 50 feet tall.
right. With my full baskets, I'm going to go up to the farmers, and using the fire tornado as an example, I'm going to try to convince them that the best idea for them is to go to the wombats, because they have a plan to get to safety.
Okay, and you're going to do this with a smoke method up your ass?
Smoke method up my ass? Yeah, kind of like, you know, farm's already in some big danger right now. You got the food that we can get. Maybe it's best for us to abandon and seek refuge, and for them to seek refuge in with the wombats right now in the village.
He is going to take one quick pot shot, and he will hit two of you with some cinder breath. And let's see. Dratar and somebody else. Ori. So make a DC 10 dexterity saving throw.
All right.
Okay. So Ari is blinded until the end of the method's next turn. And the rest of you, well, Ari can too. You can all take a whack at it and you'll probably kill it before it gets another turn.
Yeah, Kalendor is going to drop his basket, draw his greatsword, and charge in. Swinging at it.
Totally getting the crab with a knife.
Yep, just go ahead and roll your attack. I'm just being a little bit loosey-goosey about it because you're probably going to kill it before it gets another turn. So I just wanted it to get one paw shot and then you guys can kill it.
You're good. Yep, 24, I'm guessing, hits.
Yes, it does. Does not have a high armor class.
See, I hit it with my greatsword and...
Go ahead, guys. Just throw them out there. Just go ahead and attack.
Lash through the cinders.
Okay, nine sliver. And he passed. And Kalendor the crab had some kind of hiccup.
I was trying to read what Mind Sliver did. Because it said share spell description.
I wonder why it did that. Maybe it's because you don't have ownership on it. I don't know though.
Yeah, it's not on my character sheet. Alright, so we got 11 plus 7 plus 5. That's 23 so far.
Well, that'll kill it, and then maybe, I don't know, yeah, it might not have snuck up on Ori. Like, maybe, like, I would give you advantage on your deck save, but you still didn't pass it even with advantage.
I still didn't pass. I'm not saying that. I'm just trying to give myself some sort of edge when swinging the scimitar.
But it's okay. It's dead.
Seeing as I'm blinded.
Well, you would still have disadvantage. The improved hearing is not going to...
You're not Daredevil.
You would not have disadvantage. Okay, never mind.
You are Daredevil.
I should say fighting in darkness or when blinded. But at any rate, that'll work.
All right, so we killed the fire thing, or the cinder thing.
Oh, wait. We each have our, one more thing.
Yeah.
It's got a death action.
Ooh.
There you go. It leaves behind a smoke cloud. And with the tornado, it probably would not last that long.
Oh, all right. Now I guess I'll try to persuade the farmers to leave.
Okay. It's becoming apparent that they are in danger of getting burned, and it's life or death because they don't want to leave the crops because then everybody will starve. But if they stay, you know, obviously they could burn.
Can we do another round of filling up, baskets?
Yep, and they're not very persuaded, so they're going to just keep filling up baskets. And so between all of you, I think you've got, after another round of it, you've got enough baskets to move on, but we are going to fight another smoke method. And we'll just do the same routine. And have it take a pop shot on somebody, and then y'all can just kill it.
I'm gonna punch it.
All right. You got it. Yeah, we'll just do a good old claw. And that is going to be targeting Dratar.
What'd you get for punching it?
And that is a failed save, so he takes another one psychic damage. And the rest of you can just go ahead and throw your attacks in there. And I'm sure we'll kill him. So that's 11, 19, 20, 23. That is all it takes. So he is dead. And enough food has been collected that you can get out of the way, get out of harm's way.
Does anyone else have decent persuasion, or I can try again? We've got
more. I cast guidance on you.
Cool. I guess I will try again now that we have more food collected, more food that can help the villagers that they might be in need of now that there's going to be an influx of people that are moving in towards the village.
Okay, and you have a way to turn on guidance, and I can show you how.
Oh, okay.
Character sheet here. We can go down to global skill modifier, which is under your tools for some reason. I don't know why. And guidance adds a
1d4.
1d4, okay. Thank you.
So I will re-roll that then, I guess, or should I just add the 4 to the 8 in this instance? Or it's a 1d4.
think I'm in the wrong place. Yeah, you can just roll 1d4, but
okay.
I'm just trying to automate it here, and there it is. Okay. That was one row up.
All right. Don't think I'm going to persuade them.
Okay, so you have a global skill modifier now called Guidance. So if you check that on and then like roll a skill, then you'll get the Guidance will be added to it for you.
Okay.
So if that's on, not that it hurts anything to just roll a 1d4, but I'm just letting you know it's there.
Yep, I'll use that because it does the math, so.
Cool.
Does anyone with a lower persuasion modifier want to try just for the sake of they might get a better roll?
I can try to scare them.
Yeah, let's move into intimidation. Wait, pause. Pause, 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 pause. Pause with pause. Pause.
Go to the bottle!
No, okay. No SOP on persuasion. Okay, so what is Ori's plus on persuasion? Is she proficient?
Nope. And no.
Okay, so is it only Dratar that's proficient in persuasion?
I think so.
Okay, all right. Cool. All right, then we're good. So continuing on. Okay. They're not very easily convinced, but Kalendor has convinced one of them.
That's one more than we had.
Kalendor, she's like, when you're dead, can I come back and chew on your bones?
When you die from fire, I eat cooked meat.
Why don't you guys throw some more intimidate or persuasion checks out there, whichever you're best at.
Turned from persuasion to intimidation, I guess. I tried to be nice.
I don't know why the home and end keys don't work in chat. It's annoying.
Huh. All right. Well.
All right, do we just do the same thing again to try to convince some people?
Yep, better give me one more round of it.
All righty.
All right, you know, Twist didn't throw anything in there. She can probably do either a persuasion or an intimidation.
Hey, oh, damn. Can we... I don't think we're gonna get that many people in the burrows. So how many do we end up with?
You've got 9.
Can we collectively, as a group, go back to the 9th person or the last person and be like, everyone else is leaving. You should join them for your own safety.
It's an old fart. And he is, he just wants to die at the farm.
Hey, if that's what he wants. Is there anything else for us to do then, since he's just going to sit here and die?
Well, it looks like your options are, if you're concerned about it, to pick him up against his will and physically carry him. But, like, that's kind of impractical, and... it would be going against his will. So if you're interested in that, that's one thing. But if you just, if you just want to let him have his wish, then.
Yeah, I'm all for the latter. I'm not going to force him to do what he doesn't want to. Yeah. So, I don't know about the other guys, but I will personally just walk away, I guess.
Okay. And I'm assuming I don't hear any other objections, so...
I agree and make a mental note to come back later.
Okay.
The food for him.
Yeah, either way.
I'm trying to see if there's any way I can get him a bomb.
It could be... It depends on timing, right? It could be for him, if the timing is right, or if the timing is a little different, it could be for food.
Let me try and see if I can make him a bomb.
You see,
with Twist,
when you return to the primary road, there is a bird hybrid, what appears to be a kinku, stranded on the side of the road with a broken axle. He introduces himself as Whippoorwill, and he was on his way to the village when his horse Clip-Clop got spooked by the fire and the cart crashed, breaking the wheel off one of the axles. Whippoorwill is currently stuck with no transportation on their way to the village to escape the fire. Characters who are proficient with land vehicles, carpenter's tools, or smith tools may be able to help fix the wagon. Clip Clop is a short distance away, going back towards the farm. And he can be wrangled up with a survival or animal handling or nature check.
Nice.
Hey, all right. Okay. Better than new. Thank you, sir.
He now has a clockwork wagon that doesn't have to be pulled by the horse that we just got back.
Thank you, sir. Much obliged. And now we try to persuade him to go to the burrow.
Well, wasn't he already on his way to the burrow?
Or he's on his way to the village.
He's on his way to the village.
Oh, to the village.
Can I make an insight check to see if he's sketchy at all or anything?
Yeah. I know the icon looked sketchy, but...
Okay.
No, he's really not. The icon looks kind of evil, but... he's nice.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, then I guess I'll persuade him to go to the burrow instead of the village.
I'll go ahead and add guidance to that.
Cool. Oh, really?
Or charming half-orc.
All right, so you have persuaded him to return to the village. Moving on. You see an orc nearby casting something.
Make an arcana check to see if I know what it is from this distance.
Go ahead and roll it. He is casting Fireball. And you see that streak out and reduce the vegetation and crops in its radius to ash.
I let the party know that he's casting Fireball, like what he's doing, just to fill him in. And I suggest we go stop him.
He may have started the fire tornado thing at the other farm, so yeah.
He may have started the fire.
Calendar, what do you think? Anyone opposed to stopping him? Okay, guess not. So I will head towards him. But far enough to where I know I won't.
Whoa, wait a minute. Wait a minute. That does not look like the right map. That is not the right map. Okay, hold on. Sorry. One sec. There it is. That's the one I was looking for. Oh, and there's a previous encounter on here. We can just ignore that. And you guys will be entering on the southwest side.
I just want to make sure no one had any, like, opposition to, like, trying to stop this guy, right?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Nobody spoke up, so I'm going to assume no.
Okay. Cool. Do we need to move our characters here again?
I'm just going to... well, you need to drag them onto the field, yes. Onto okay. the southwest side. Like right in the bottom square. I'll just adjust if necessary. And there should be one more. Is it twist that we're missing? I think that's twist. Who are we missing down here?
I believe Kalendor.
The Kalendor, yeah.
We're missing the grab crab.
Okay. All right. I need everybody to roll initiative, please. And you'll have to select your tokens before you roll initiative so that it goes, because it won't go on the turn order if you don't. And yeah. Aloran, you didn't have your character selected when you rolled initiative. It has to have a token to associate with.
Again.
I think we lost Kalendor for a minute.
Dang, 2 nat 20? Did I do it wrong again? Okay.
It's showing you on the list now. So you got a nat 20 again, okay. Can go first. Remember, you can use the measurement tool or the Q key to measure how far away things are, how far you're moving, or spell distances or missile distances or whatever.
Yeah, sorry, could you go over that again? Q?
Yeah, you can press Q to turn on the measurement tool. Whoa, that should have worked. And you can, I forgot to turn on this key shot. Okay. Yeah, you can press Q to turn on the measurement tool, or you can select your token, and while you're dragging your token, you can press Q to like make a measurement with your token.
Doesn't seem to be working for me.
So, or you can just use the toolbar. There's a little ruler.
Yeah. Okay. Alright. I will use my movement to move up. Is it 6 squares for 30 feet?
Yeah.
Is diagonal considered one, or?
It's diagonal is 1 square. Yeah.
I'm gonna sprint behind him as well. Or wait, your turn's not done. Sorry.
I mean, I don't think I can do anything from this far. Yeah, you can go ahead. Oh wait, I lied. I can cast magic missile from 120 feet. So I will do that. I'll use a first level spell slot to cast magic missile.
Sorry, one sec, I'm looking for something. Everything's just kind of moving a little sluggishly. Still running the search query. Yep, okay, that's interesting. Okay, all right, whatever. Do you have anything else you can do other than that?
I don't think so.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. I'm gonna move my character 30 feet as well. I definitely can't do anything from range, so I will. Yeah, pass my turn.
Okay, twist. Somebody logged off.
I think it was Kalendor.
Okay. Yeah, he is, it looks like, having some kind of something going on. Because he just kind of poofed.
Oh. Sorry, wrong button.
We'll see if he makes it back, but anyway.
I was just trying to see the range on that. I'm going to miss him for 2 whole fire damages.
Okay.
And that's the end of Twist's turn.
And it is Kalindor's turn, and I feel like he got disconnected or something happened. I don't know what, because he just kind of vanished. So I'm going to just figure out what he's going to do. I think probably it's he's going to charge more or less. So right now he'll just dash in. When I have you, when you do a dash, by the way, rules is written as it has to be a totally straight line. You can do like a little bit of a turn as far as I'm concerned. Not more than probably like.
I thought that was a charge.
Maybe it is. I thought it was a dash or a charge.
I think dash just doubles your speed.
Okay. Well, either way. But that's all he can do because dash takes up all your action. So, Ori, go ahead.
Where he has 90 feet of flight. Puts her within range of There we go. DC 15 dexterity save from Mr. Orc, please.
And he passes. So.
Save or suck.
Probably. Okay. It's not half damage. You also have a bunch of props for your spells that you can use to place them, as well as just get a visual. So create bonfire is one of them, and there's a bunch of others, and they'll be probably more incoming as you guys get more spells. So I think everybody should have access to all those.
All right, Ori is done with her turn.
He is going to cast Burning Hands, and Ari has to make a dexterity saving throw at DC 15. Whoa, it's not that big. Okay. So you can save for half damage, taking 6 damage.
I'll take 3 instead.
Okay. Always nice. All right, so Aloran, go ahead.
All right. So I'll use my full movement. I take this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I will try to cast Mind Sliver. So he has to make an intelligence save.
That's a fail. So he takes the damage.
As a bonus action, can Aloran like yell out like, why are you doing this?
Yes.
I think he knows Orcish.
Can he speak Orcish would be my question.
Yeah, you can.
Okay, and can this guy respond before it's his turn? There's a word for what he's doing, or what he thinks he's doing, but I'm not sure what it is. So I'm going to explain that. He's just going to say what it is he's doing, but I'm going to have to explain it because I'm not sure what the vocabulary is. There's a way of starting controlled fires in a region that's being hit by wildfires that will deny the fire up to a certain point. It won't be able to spread anymore.
He's creating a stopgap.
Everybody make an insight check. All of you can do it.
Wow. My dice hate me on that one.
Everybody's dice hates them, apparently. So, wow, jeez. Okay, well, Aloran is understanding what he's trying to do and what he thinks he's doing, but he doesn't know how to do it, and he's really just starting fires.
And I'll end my turn with that.
Okay. Dritar, it is your turn.
Okay. So, are we still feeling to try to take this guy down or just convince him to stop starting fires? Right, no response. I'm throwing my dart. I believe I'll have disadvantage because the range.
Oh, and we flipped over to the next initiative, didn't we? Oh, let me add something on this. Go ahead. All Okay, so 8 piercing damage. Oh, he looks like he's having a bad day all of a sudden. Twist. Assuming Dratara was done.
Yes, I am done. Yes, sorry.
Now, Orcish is different than Goblin, right?
Yes, it is. Although, there's a fair probability that... There's a fair probability that a lot of orcs could understand Goblin, and there's and equally, like, a lot of goblins might understand orc, or at least some of them, so...
And it doesn't look like... Well, Twist knows Goblin, but he doesn't know Orcish.
Give it a shot if you want to talk.
I guess Twist will say... you stop... Or we continue attacking.
You don't see any comprehension on his face.
Okay. Well then. A dexterity save.
The statement was your action.
Oh, well then never mind then.
If you have to like try to get a response, that's your action. If you're just yelling something and you're not waiting for a response or anything like that, it's not an action. But you know, if you're trying to like have a two-way, then that's an action.
Okay. I don't think Twist has any bonus action stuff right now.
Okay. Yeah, bonus action spells are always good. Kalendor is going to charge. I don't know if he has any special charging abilities or what. It doesn't look like it. But he is just going to go for it. And he cleaves him in twain. And this guy is making some more little fires. So, probably the thing to do is just GTFO. Let me see if there's anything interesting on this guy. It looks like there's not.
So on to the next farm, the fire's kind of, I mean, we can't really do anything about it. No water, no sand. Might be something to tell the wombats about, though.
Okay.
Yeah, I agree. Wait, so did the orc, like, run off?
I think the word you're looking for is controlled burn.
I I think, if I'm not mistaken, a controlled burn is, it's just burning, and it's done to fertilize, and you do it proactively, like you don't do it once the fires start.
It's done to eliminate undergrowth from trees, so that the fire can be easier, or can be combated easily, as opposed to having all that undergrowth turned into tinder and flashing across the forest.
Gotcha. Okay. But the basic idea just being that you, like, you do a particular way of setting fires, you do like a controlled burn, and you deny the fire a bunch of fuel by strategically setting these other fires. And that's what he was trying to do. And he believed that's what he was doing. But like I said, he just really was just starting fires.
But did he run off then, or?
No, he was sliced in half.
Oh, okay.
By Kalendor.
Gotcha.
Yeah, I guess let's move on to the next farm.
Yeah, I agree.
If I'm not moving the party travel incorrectly, or
so you gotta click back on the toolbar on the left, you gotta click back to the first one.
Yes.
Approaching the next farm, you can see that there is an Ifriti kind of skulking around the farm that has not noticed you yet.
I'm sorry, a what?
Ifriti?
Can we assume that it's bad?
Fire genie.
You can absolutely assume anything you want.
Can I make an insight check to see if he is? Well, I feel like.
Yeah. Let's see here. I can't do this. Give me a sec here.
Yep, insight failed me again.
You would say yes.
He
is bad.
Okay. I was gonna say, if I knew you were making an insight check, I would have helped with that. Okay. I would look to the group and ask if we want
really
to
bad.
Put how that, we ask how we want to approach this.
You can put that in your standard operating procedures.
Okay.
Yeah, if you roll insight, I'll help. If I roll insight, you help.
Sounds good. Yeah, so like I said, I would ask the group how we want to handle this.
I would say without fire.
Yeah, I'm probably just gonna punch it. That's worked out for me kind of well. I don't think we should assume it's good.
but we know it's not, so.
Yeah, so fire genies. I'd say, I mean, oops, I'm down to fight it.
All right, well, let's do it then.
At level one, we probably shouldn't fight Nepri.
What if we taunt it?
YOLO.
It shall become so cross that it would make a mistake.
I'm down to try that.
Now, you and Alorian and Tratar jump out of the wooden horse and attack the Ifrit. Who jumps out of the wooden horse? You and Alorian and Dritar. You tit! You fat gob! Run away! Okay, everybody make an insight check and don't critically fail it.
I'm just gonna help.
Is it for each of us, or like, can we help each other?
You can be considered to be helping each other.
Can you roll my insight check for me? My browser just crashed.
For which character? Sorry.
Both of them. My browser just crashed.
I think everyone besides Tratar and Alora need to have insight rolls done for them.
There you go. Okay, so everybody can see plainly that assaulting this creature is suicide. There is no possible way you can successfully fight this creature right now.
All right, I'd say we save our own hides and,
get out
of here. We're getting like, you know, we're batting like 60% on these farms right now. So like, no, we've only done two. So 40%, that's good in baseball or this world's equivalent.
Yeah, I'm down to leave.
Everybody make a perception check.
You make Ori's and Ed as well.
Lauren, very perceptive.
I saw my nat 20s on that initiative roll.
I always take improved initiative because, I mean, not always, but almost always. Because I feel like the most powerful character in the world, like, it doesn't matter if you can't get in there and go. Okay, well, everybody except Aloran has noticed that a koala druid has appeared by your side, and she apparently snuck up very, very quietly. And she is saying, I need those sap trees to harvest 5 vials of gum sap. She has medicine that will work really well on burns, and it creates a healing salve. It needs to be harvested before the trees are lost in the blaze. If you have someone among you who can avoid detection by the Ifrit while harvesting the sap, she would be most appreciative.
Do I just not know that this qual is there, or do I just not see it initially?
I would say you just didn't see it initially. You probably figured it out when she started talking, so.
Okay.
I have a +6 on my stealth, but I don't know if I want to risk it, because I have good persuasion, and I rolled some pretty bad stuff.
All averages, it'll cancel out.
How big are these vials?
Yeah, I think she said she needed 4 of them. They're like the average, probably about the size of a test tube, give or take.
If I summon a familiar, would I be able to have the familiar do it?
Ari will do it.
Yeah, probably.
And summoning a familiar would take an hour.
Oh, you don't have it. Okay, you haven't called your familiar yet. Okay.
Yeah, it's yeah. So on the operations thing, could I make something saying that, like, before each adventure, I cast a ritual for something familiar?
Yep.
Or find familiar? Okay, yep. Cool.
You only need to do that, like, once.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. You only need to, like, once you've summoned it, it's your familiar.
So we can say you have a familiar, because I'm pretty sure you logically would have summoned it when you found out you knew how to do it.
I don't do that. If he didn't cast it, he didn't cast it.
Yeah, so I was gonna say it's not that important. I'll do it next time.
Ari will fucking go in there and harvest sap and GTFO, because Ari has a 90 flight speed and.
Oh, if she has 90 and she can fly, I'm pretty sure she can outrun it. If it came down to it.
Yeah.
Have Ari make a stealth check. And then nature or survival are your two choices to get the sap.
All right.
Go ahead when you're ready. All right, good stealth. Okay, you got the sap, and you did not alert the Ifrit of your presence.
See if I can get some extra sap while I'm down there. Or is the fire up on us now?
That's probably going to be, like, you can try, but you'll probably take some fire damage. So if you want to try it, I'll roll a little fire damage. And that's not going to get you any more sap anyway. And you will take 3 fire damage.
All right, I'm getting out of there.
Okay.
You want me to roll another stealth check, or?
No, just the one's good. Okay, Fola thanks you and tells you that this medicine will have a very positive help, very positive effect on helping the villagers who have been burned. She just couldn't. She had to get away from it when that Afridi showed up.
But hopefully those trees are able to grow back stronger after the Afridi leaves.
Oh yeah, they will eventually, but It takes a while. Everything that's being burned will grow back and better, but the more immediate concerns.
All right, well, I say we get out of here before the Afridi spots us.
Yeah, I agree. I think there's... Is there one more farm that we haven't been to?
Yes.
Okay, so I would assume that's where we head to next. I think it's...
It's like the first farm, yeah, because we like passed it.
Yeah.
So right now, you don't see anyone or anything happening around the farm, or you know what you can see with an eye shot. There appears to be some crops, but it looks like most of them have been burnt. There's not much sound other than the sounds you would expect to hear from the nearby critters and such. So
judging by what happened to all the other farms, can I make a perception check to see if I notice anything?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'll help him with perception if he needs it.
So it's kind of hard to notice at like where things stand right now. It's kind of hard to notice when there's smoke or smoldering in the air, because it's just kind of all the time and your olfactory senses sort of shut down after a time, because at some point it's not new information anymore. But you can notice the faint smell of charred flesh permeating the smoky, ashy smell.
I would let the group know that and ask if we should check it out.
Sure.
Or at least find where the scent's coming from, to be more specific.
Yeah, I mean, burnt flesh is never good, so we should investigate it.
You find the corpse of a farmer who has been badly immolated and did not survive his wounds. He seems to be holding something in his hands that is hard to identify because it's been burned. But when you when you look closer, it looks like maybe some of it might have survived.
I'm gonna try to, get it out of his hands.
Do an investigation check.
Oh boy, okay. Hey, okay.
Alright, so we have got a note of some sort. He was squeezing it so that, what I mean is he was squeezing it tight, and it looks like what was inside his hand survived, and the outside edges burned. When you pull the note out, the wax seal remains with a signet marking on it. I guess somehow it didn't melt in the fire. I don't know how.
Can I make a perception? You said there's what on it? There's a seal?
Yes. You know how, like, you would seal letters and stuff, and you'd put wax on it, and then you'd stamp it with your signet ring?
And Can I make a perception check to see if I recognize the seal at all? Like, if there's anything noteworthy about it?
I don't think that would be perception, but I'm not sure off the top of my head what it would be.
Okay. I can make another investigation.
I think, really, you know what? How about history?
History
or investigation, whichever is better. And you can have other people look at it, too.
Okay. Yeah, since
I'll throw guidance down to whoever wants it.
Yeah, since I'm proficient in both, so whatever you decide.
I am not, so you can take that if you'd like.
Okay, so roll whichever one you like. And let me check something real quick before we go any further with this. I just want to see. Okay, the signet ring, the signature is from a messenger that is kind of regionally famous for being very, very fast, and her name is Iris, and she is the person who delivered this message.
I guess that was my check.
I should say she is the mouse hybrid that delivered this message.
Okay. Yeah, I let the group know my findings. I tell that Iris is a mouse hybrid that delivered this and everything that he said. Well, I guess they're all there to figure that out too.
Alrighty.
Might be rude to open it.
I mean, I personally, but I wouldn't be opposed to somebody else opening it.
Well,
I bet it would be important to somebody else.
The crab is clearly an instigator, so I guess the crab will come by and just snip it open. And so it kind of unrolls in your hand, and you don't know what the text says, but you quickly recognize it as being the same language as the note that you have that was passed on to you by your family.
Interesting. Yeah, so I fill the group in, and I let them know that I do have this note. I don't know what language it is, what language it's in. I got it from my family, and this looks to be the same language. I haven't been able to find anything to decipher what this says.
In what languages do you know?
I know common, dwarvish, elvish, orcish, and halfling.
All right, you know more languages than me, and I know elvish and orcish, so I will not be able to help you there.
Well, I know druidic, common, draconic, celestial, giant, and sylvan.
Yeah, so I would show it to you and see if you knew, if you could see what any of those languages are, what this is in.
And Twist just has common and sylvan.
And goblin.
What language do we consider Kalendor to speak?
Ari has celestial, common, draconic, and druidic.
And did giant you, and sylvan at the bottom.
Did you say that already? Giant and sylvan as well. Okay. What language does who speak?
Like, what do we consider, like, do hybrids just know, like, common? Is there, like, a hybrid language?
It will usually be, no, there is not. It will usually be common, or they might have other languages sometimes, and it will say in their, like, in their entry in the world book.
Okay, cool.
There is no, like, hybrid common. Okay, so... Dratar is not able to make anything out of it. Who else is looking at it? Sorry.
Ari and Twist.
Twist is not able to make anything out of it. Ori recognizes it as some form of celestial that she doesn't recognize. Maybe something... Well, have Ari make a... trying to decide... have her make an Arcana check. Okay, it appears to be an ancient form of celestial that is no longer widely known, so it's hard to say when this language was commonly used. It's impossible to say why there are notes written in it, and for now it's impossible to decipher.
I would ask if I could hold on to the note. I don't know who has it, actually. But I would ask whoever has it if I could hold on to it.
I mean, right now, I guess Ori has it because she was able to decipher some of the origins of it, but... I suppose. I don't see any harm in you holding it.
Either. I'll add that to my inventory.
If you let me study it, I might be able to decipher some, but we'd require a little bit more of an established area than this.
Does the language have a check? Like, can you, like, make a celestial language check? Some versions you can. I don't know if 5th edition does that. I think 5th edition just says if you can speak it, you can speak it.
Yeah.
Right, okay, so why don't you just do a just another Arcana, let's do that.
I could do like a wisdom check or something like that.
I have Arcana, I don't know if I can do it.
No, you have to have Celestial too.
Okay.
Yay for being proficient in Arcana. Well, you can help me then, if you're proficient in Arcana.
Yeah.
He can't help you because he doesn't know the language. You're trying to read something on the page, and you have picked up a name. Inato.